Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to enable editing in the Angular Gantt chart component. I will also show you how to perform cell, dialog, taskbar, and dependency editing in Gantt charts. First, I open my existing application, where I have installed the Angular Gantt package, and all the modules of the Gantt chart are configured in the app module page. In the app component HTML page, I have added the basic rendering code of Gantt chart. In the data.ts file, I defined the hierarchical object project new data with a collection of tasks. I added fields like task ID, task name, and so on to a single task. I also added the subtasks field to define child tasks. I added other tasks as well, with appropriate parent and subtasks. In the appComponent.html page, I assign that project data to the datasource property of the Gantt chart component. You can refer to my Angular Gantt chart getting started video to learn more about configuring the component. I've shared a link to it in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application. See here, the left pane has a tree grid with hierarchical data, and the right pane has a chart with a project timeline to represent the project duration. We already know that Gantt features are segregated into modules. To use the editing feature, I open the app module page and import the edit service from the EJ2 Angular Gantt package and inject it into the provider's array of the NG module. Then, to enable this feature, I navigate to the app component page, add the public variable edit options of object type and the allow editing property. I set its value to true. Then, I assign this variable to the edit settings property of the Gantt chart. Look here, on the tree grid side, I can start editing any cell by double-clicking on it, and that cell will change to edit mode. I can edit any data, and the changes will be reflected in the chart. On the chart side, I can edit the task using the edit dialog by double-clicking on the taskbars. In the task information dialog, when I change the start date of the child record, the end date will automatically be adjusted, since the duration is set to 4 days. The end date of its parent task will also be adjusted. Coming to the editing modes, Gantt has two, auto and dialog. Just now, we saw the default auto mode. To enable the dialog editing mode, I add the mode property and set its value to dialog in edit settings. See now, a dialog has popped up in both the tree grid and chart for editing. To demonstrate other features with better understanding, I'll change the mode back to auto. Next, I will show you how to enable CRUD operations in the toolbar. To enable the toolbar, I open the app module page, import toolbar service from the Angular Gantt package, and inject it into the provider's array of the NG module. I navigate to the app component page. I declare the variable toolbar options of string array type and will define the options to be displayed in the toolbar. Gantt toolbar has various built-in options: add, edit, update, delete, cancel, expand all, collapse all, indent, and outdent. Then, I need to enable the CRUD operations in the edit settings. I enable the properties allow adding and allow deleting in the edit options. Assign this toolbar options variable to the toolbar property of Gantt chart. Checking the tree grid toolbar now, only three options are shown on rendering. Before we look into the edit and delete options, let me enable the selection feature for a better user experience. So, I open the app module page, import the selection service module, and inject it in the provides array of the NG module. Then, I enable an allow selection property. As you can see, when I click the Add button, a new task dialog will pop up with default values. I enter my values and save the changes. In the same way, I can edit the record. Here in the Dependency tab, I can add a new dependency or delete the existing one. Click this option to delete the selected record. The child tasks will collapse on clicking the Collapse All button and expand on clicking the Expand All button. Now, I'll show you how to perform editing in the taskbar. I can modify the task details by resizing or dragging the taskbar. To enable this feature, I add the allow taskbar editing property and set its value to true. Checking now, when I place the cursor over the taskbar, the kebab menu is shown. I can change the start and end dates of the task by resizing it. If I change the dates in the child task, it will be reflected in the parent task. I can drag the taskbar to change the dates. I can also edit the dependency connector lines using the drag and drop action with connector line points available on either side of the taskbar. In this video, I have shown you how to enable editing with toolbar options in the Gantt chart component and its various modes. I also showed you how to enable taskbar editing and dependency editing. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.